I feel like when you just type in vaccines on Google, there's so much that comes up and half the stuff you can't even pronounce.
I counted like over 20 vaccines on his vaccination card. He's a year and a half. He's not even 2 years old.
That happened to me recently with my kid.
But I've never really questioned why. I never thought about how many would be in the long run.
Y'all ready?
All right, you guys ready?
I'm Dr. Erica Gonzalez. I am a mother of two boys. So I have been practicing medicine now for about 20 years. I initially did my training in pediatrics in the Air Force and then specialized in allergy, asthma, and immunology. I think that this discussion that we're having today is extremely important because unfortunately over the past, 10 years or so, there's been so much misinformation about vaccines. And of course, as mothers, we're going to pay attention to that, and it's going to make us start questioning whether we're doing the right thing for our kids.
I don't really know why I'm vaccinating my child. Like, what's the purpose?
I feel like when it comes to vaccines, I don't really have a lot of knowledge about them. And I feel like so many people in my life have come up to me and have given me their opinion or told me what to do, but then I want to feel like I can make a decision for myself.
I've never stopped and questioned why. Really, I'm just here to get information about vaccines and I guess to see what's best for my family moving forward.
I think that it's important to know that vaccines have been around for quite a while now, and because of that, we're able to confidently say that they not only are safe for our children, but are effective. And so part of my job as a physician and a pediatrician is to make sure that when moms come in with questions, that I'm there to try to alleviate any concerns that they might have. And in my professional opinion, I think that the best thing you can do to keep your kids protected is to get them vaccinated.
With me being such a new mom and this new experience, I'm just now getting mom friends, and I haven't really seen too many like side effects or kids having issues when they're not vaccinated. But I have heard horror stories of what can happen if people don't get their kids vaccinated.
Most devastating consequence from not getting your kids vaccinated would be for them to get the disease and die from it. Unfortunately, death is not the only bad outcome that can happen. There's patients that have the disease, and even though they may not die, they may suffer serious consequences. So you can see death, brain damage, deafness, paralysis. Those are probably the most devastating things that can happen if you don't get your kids vaccinated.
For me, I feel like when I take my daughter to the doctor, half the time I don't even know she's about to get a vaccine.
I leave the pediatrician feeling like having many other questions. And, my husband's always like, did you ask this? Do you ask that? Why didn't you ask? And I'm like, I don't know, because it just felt like really rushed. I do feel that time pressure.
They'll ask you if you have any more questions, but like, do they really mean it? Or is it just, like you said, a social cue, like, okay, we're wrapping up now, so.
So thank you, bye.
Yeah. Our primary job is to make sure that our patients get their questions answered. If there's something that you still feel wasn't answered fully, or you still have a question on, don't be afraid to speak up. That healthcare is not a privilege, it's a right. And so our job is to answer those questions.
This conversation definitely opened my eyes to a lot of things that I wasn't really aware of. My views have definitely changed. So thank you, Dr. Gonzalez.
In the past months, this conversation has been only between my husband and I, because I feel judged outside of the home. But you've definitely given me confidence on having questions for my doctor. I just want to be informed and make the best decisions.
At the end of the day, you want your children to be safe and healthy. So that should be the most important thing.
thank you very much, you guys, for your vulnerability and for your courage and for trusting me to answer those questions.